In this video, I tell you the difference between thermostatic expansion valve and a capillary tubes. Okay. Now both the device, thermostatic expansion valve and capillary tube, are used in a refrigeration and air conditioning systems. Okay. So both are used for the expansion process, that is isenthalpic expansion is carried out, but which condition which is used and which is suitable for the particular systems, that I tell you in these differences. Okay, so I tell you the different 8 points. Now the first point is that it is an expansion valve, so it's one type of the expansion valve, and capillary tube is a thin type tube used for a expansion. So expansion valve is, that is a one type of the valve that is look like this image, and this capillary tube is a thin diameter tube. Okay. So this expansion valve and capillary tube is installed between the condenser and evaporators to reduce the pressure. So expansion valve is used for the reducing this pressure, okay, at the constant enthalpy. So in the some system we use the expansion valve, in some system we use the capillary tubes. Okay. So after showing the total difference, we are able in which condition we use the expansion valve and which condition we use to the capillary tubes. Okay, so this is the basic difference. Second point, before going second point, I request you to subscribe my channels and like the video. It's give us motivations to make more video. Okay. Now the second point is that the thermostatic expansion valve is used in the large refrigerant capacity systems, means where the capacity of the system is large, at that time expansion valve is used, and when the small refrigerant capacities, we use the capillary tubes. Okay. Third point is that the pressure drop is high in expansion valve, so when we require the higher pressure drops, at that time we use the expansion valve, and the capillary tube is used when the pressure drop is low. Pressure drop means we reduce the pressure from condenser pressure to the evaporator pressure. When this pressure drop is larger or the high, we use the expansion valve, and when this pressure drop is low, we use the capillary tubes. When this pressure drop is high, at that time we require the more starting torque to the compressor motors. Okay, when the pressure drop is high, that suction pressure is lower, at that why we require the more torque at the compressor motors. In this capillary tube, the pressure drop is low, so we are required a less starting torques. Okay, so that is another difference. Then the efficiency of the expansion valve is high, because it's the pressure drop is high, and its efficiency of the particular component is high. I'm not telling about the performance of the refrigeration systems, I just telling the efficiency of expansion valve, individual component efficiency of the expansion valve is high, and the efficiency of the capillary tube is low because its pressure drop is low. Next, the cost is high of the expansion valve because it's the complicated constructions, it's the content, the number of parts, so it's the cost is high. In capillary tube is a simple thin diameter tubes, okay, so it's the cost is lower. Next difference is that when we use the expansion valve, we require the receivers to separate the liquid and vapors. When we use the capillary tubes, the receiver is not required. Okay, so receiver is just separate the liquid and vapor particles that's coming out after the expansion valve device. Next difference is that starting torque for motor driving compressor is high. As I earlier told that in the expansion valve, pressure drop is high. When the pressure drop is high, then we require the starting torque of the compressor motor is high. In capillary tube, pressure drop is low, that's why starting torque of the motor driving compressor is also low. And last point is that it's a thermostatic expansion valve have a complicated constructions, that's why its cost is high. Capillary tube has a simple construction because it's a simple small diameter copper tube is wound, and it is known as the capillary tube, so its cost is lowered. So this is the difference. Okay, when have the larger capacity, we use expansion valve. We have smaller capacity, we use the capillary tubes. Where we require the larger pressure difference, pressure drop in the expansion device, then we use the thermostatic expansion valve. When we require the lower pressure drop, then we use the capillary tubes. Okay, and this is the other differences. Thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video, subscribe the channels, and share with your friend.